There are moments that last a second, and there are moments that live on forever. Today, we continue to live in a forever moment. What started as one moment around one idea to reach every person, everywhere, for Jesus, turned into a monumental movement, the Assemblies of God. These are our moments. The Azusa Street Revival, an interracial revival, was one of the focal points of the emerging Pentecostal movement. Five ministers issued a call to come to Hot Springs, Arkansas. 300 Pentecostal leaders from around the U.S. gathered. There, the Assemblies of God came into existence. E.N. Bell, a well-educated Baptist pastor, was filled with the Holy Spirit and became a prominent pastor and editor of a Pentecostal newspaper, Word and Witness. He was elected as the first chairman of the Assemblies of God. This one man, Bell, was the first leader of a movement that is now 66 million. In 1913, J. Roswell Flower and his wife, Alice, founded what became the Pentecostal Evangel. Within this magazine, Alice authored the first weekly Pentecostal Sunday School curriculum. At the Second General Council in 1914, a group of men and women delegates resolved to commit the Assemblies of God to the greatest evangelism the world has ever seen. Smith Wigglesworth, a larger-than-life British plumber turned evangelist, traveled the world and saw many people saved and healed. Smith exhibited a supernatural faith that is vibrant today in the movement. Over 20% of the AG today is Hispanic. This can be traced to two of the most prominent early missionary pioneers to the Hispanic community in the U.S., H.C. Ball and Juan Lugo. Lillian Trasher was possibly the best-known Assemblies of God missionary, one of the first women foreign missionaries in the AG. As a single woman, she went to Egypt as a missionary in 1910. One night, she was called out to a 16-year-old mother who was dying with no hope for her young baby girl. When another woman was going to throw the baby in a canal, Lillian ran with the baby back to the mission house. That was the moment that sparked the start of the largest Christian orphanage in Egypt. Robert and Mary Craig were pioneers in San Francisco, where they founded Glad Tidings Temple, a hub for Pentecostal revival, and started what became Bethany University. Ralph Riggs took Christian education to a new level and championed the development of liberal arts education in the Assemblies of God. This led the way for higher education for ministers. He was the catalyst for opening what is now Evangel University in 1955. Chi Alpha, started in 1953, now has ministries on over 300 non-AG college campuses, secular universities included. Mark and Huldah Buntain moved to Calcutta, India in 1954, where they ministered among the sick and homeless. They started a hospital and research center, which eventually became Mission of Mercy. In 1958, Teen Challenge was formed, a ministry to gang members and people with addictions. There are now over 1,000 Teen Challenge centers around the world. Charlie Lee was a nationally accomplished Navajo artist who became one of the best-known Native American Assemblies of God leaders. Millions of people in non-Pentecostal churches experienced salvation, healing, and baptism in the Holy Spirit from the late 1950s through the 1980s. Many involved in this charismatic renewal joined the AG during this time frame, and the fellowship doubled in size. Founded in 1994, Convoy of Hope has served more than 62 million people around the world through feeding initiatives, community outreaches, and disaster response. The local Assemblies of God Church provides the opportunity to expand our reach. It exists for everyone to worship, grow, and experience unique ministry opportunities. Discipleship, Sunday school, small groups, men's, women's, youth, and children's ministries facilitate congregational evangelism within our movement. These moments from our history are lasting forever. Just like God worked in these people and moments, He works through you and me. As we enter the next 100 years, God continues to write our history. our story is far from over. He is still calling us to care, commit, and carry His gospel. We will break new ground, walk into uncharted territory, and push the envelope. This is our moment. We are the movement. We are the Assemblies of God.